what he was doing within a couple of weeks of selling tabletop advertising. And I said, I got to see it to believe it. I said, I jumped in the car with him for a half a day, watched him sell two ads, and next day, I was doing it. I mean, I literally was doing consulting previous, and I literally put that on a part-time side and started going over there, and we've never looked back since. It's been a great ride, and the future does look really bright. And I really believe that there is going to be national opportunities out there for folks. And Bill's right. I mean, what's going to happen when you can sell a national ad on 2,000 tabletops, 2,000 projects across the country, and you know, you become literally almost an instant millionaire. We can do the rest of the year. So it'll be a big dream, big goals. All right. So that being said, I'll let Eric kind of give it. I do come from a business owner background. I was in the convenience store, gas station, car wash business for 14 years. I was one of those business owners at that time that the business owned me. I didn't own it, you know what I mean? And literally 14 years took one vacation, and that was a nightmare. Don't miss it, we'll go back. And through this opportunity to become a real business owner, where you actually can control your destiny. I love the idea that we don't have to babysit our employees, but I have a lot of great people part of our business team. And the bottom line is, have the opportunity where we can make little as much as you want. And if you're willing to do the effort, you can make create a very lucrative income. And in the beginning, we did what it took to make it work. We look back, 11, 12, as many as 15 years ago, and look what we were doing, and we kind of chucked. All right, but we were paving the way. We were paving the way for the success that that we're experiencing now, and we credit a lot of the success that we have now based on the work and things that we did back then. And so, I think it's important you understand that, because a lot of people just get into something and they want to make a buck, just like we did. But you look at it short-term, you don't look at long-term, so you love having to make short-term decisions, which don't allow you to have a long-term success. And so we made a decision that we're going to do it right from the beginning. We built our company with integrity and character. We have phenomenal relationships with our business owners. And that is why, like Bill said, you hear the closing ratios that we have. It's because we did things right at the beginning. Just a lot of things that continue to roll, all right? And, so that being said, I'll let Eric kind of give his background. I do have four children, all daughters. God knew I needed a lot of patience. I'm not kidding. Anyway, I have three great-grandchildren. They're all boys. I'm sorry, three grandchildren. They're all boys. So you see how it works? I told my daughter, I said, y'all get ready. I said, I'm expecting 10 grandsons. I've got three so far, no granddaughters, and we're just going to keep rolling. So it's a lot of fun in our household, but here's Eric. You don't want to mess with me? I'm going.
Okay, one thing I'll get into here. So there are some people here that recognize us, that we are doing, know our background is. I used to coach gymnastics for 20 years, so all that Olympic stuff you saw on TV this past summer, that's why I used to teach. You're like, how the heck did you get into doing this? Okay, this was a bad business deal. I had sold my gymnastics school years ago, and not listening to my wife, she said, why don't you just close it down and do something different? And I had dreams of getting into a bigger facility, so I decided to move it in. I went from a 3,000 square foot facility to a 10,000 square foot facility, which is a much bigger endeavor. You would think that the people would come, and they were. And I had a guy come in and say to me, hey, I'd like to buy your school. Is it for sale? Well, anything's for sale, okay? If I said to Mr. Crabtree, hey, Bill, I'm going to offer you $20 million for your business. A little bit higher? Okay, $50 million. Is that for sale? Yes, it is. Everything's for sale. So I didn't listen to my wife. I decided to sell it, but I do a bad business deal. But a six-figure debt back to somebody because this guy skipped out. I'm not going to give you all the details of it, but not a good thing to be in. And we ended up, I used to have a sheriff come to my house. Miss what I would hear. And I told my wife, don't you dare open that door, because they wanted to share us our house. They tried to repossess our cars. I'm not trying to give you a sad story, honestly. And then I'm out there selling something else one day. And this guy says to me, hey, I used to do what you do. I go, what do you mean? And he goes, you work for a company called Fanfare Media out of Orange County, California. How the heck did you know this? He goes, I did it. I did it down in Virginia. And he says, I'll show you what I do a little bit later on, finish up your presentation. So I finish it up, I make the sale. And I said, you need to show me what you do. He says, come here. We go outside of the trunk of his car. He opens up the trunk and he shows me this table. And I said, what is that? He said, these are tables we're putting in a restaurant down the street here. I went, don't even tell me. People sit there for 45 minutes, a lot of waiting for their food. They read the ads on the table. He's like, yeah. I go, what about the placements that they put on the table? Like a cloth or a piece of paper? He goes, nope, it's in the contract. They're not allowed to do that. I'm like, hold on for a second. I get my cell phone out at the time. I pick it up as one of the big ones. And I'm like, hey, Ricky, this is Eric. He goes, hey, how's it going? I'm like, man, you never know. Everybody always does that when you talk on the phone. I say, hey, Ricky, this is Eric. He said, how's it going? I'm like, fantastic. I said, I'm giving you my 2-week notice. I'll explain to you later on. I hang up the phone. God looks at me and goes, you just quit your job? I said, yeah. Can you teach me that? And he goes, absolutely. A couple months later, he's gone. Tabletop Productions is born. I call Bill Crabtree. He says, you think you can do this? I'm like, yep. He says, give me a call on Monday. I call him back on Monday. I said, I got a business partner that wants to work with me. He goes, is he any training? I'm like, nope, I'll take care of him. Don't worry about it. And we have just taken off. So I went from teaching gymnastics to selling ads. Couldn't figure it out. But here's what I did know, that there were bigger plans for me. I wasn't aware of it, and I had to reach rock bottom to figure out something else to do. And I took a leap of faith. I just jumped right in because I had nowhere else to go. I hope nobody else has to experience what we did. That's just my story. Keith was always successful. So whenever he saw me doing this, I'm thinking, for me, it was a no-brainer. I'm very creative, okay? I'm as sharp as a marble, but I'm always on a roll. That's my claim to fame. Seriously, I'm dangerous. But man, just push me along the way and I'll go. But he's the businessman, okay? I'm just very creative. And with that combination, we were able to develop such a great relationship. Do we bump heads every once in a while? Yeah, but you have to be able to already said that. So I think it's important to kind of set up where we came from. Keith was not a salesman. He sat in the office. He told people to, pump gas. He babysat a bunch of employees at his gas station. And that was it. He did some other stuff too. So anyways, one of the things that has helped us become successful, and we will get into the presentation. I promise you, Mark, we will do the presentation. Okay? One of the things that we need to understand is that, or you need to understand, you've been doing this for 15 years. So, go back 14, 15 years ago. If you're brand new here, we were you. We were struggling. We were selling one ad a week. And we were excited about selling one ad a week. Or having no sales Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And then Keith would call me and say, Eric, man, it's Thursday evening. I got five confirmed appointments for Friday. Friday's going to be a great day. And he would turn around and call me and say, Eric, I sold 4 out of 5 ads. I'm like, that's awesome. Oh, you suck. I'm saying that in a positive way. Don't get me wrong, okay? It's a positive thing, okay? So we just kept paving the way. And here's what we have figured out. If you have work and you times it by the right people that want to do this, and you times it by the time that you put in, you'll succeed at this. So you got your work ethic, you're finding the right people that say yes, you got to find ones that say no, that's okay. But you're willing to put the time in, you're going to be successful at this. And that's exactly what he and I have done. Now, because of the 15 years, it's coming back to us that we don't work as hard because of Everybody knows us now in Pittsburgh. They know the tabletop guys. They know our product. Do we still work hard? Yes. Now, there's different ways to present things, okay? I'm going to show you something that I do that is completely different. I don't know if Keith has ever done it, but this is what I'm doing now, where I'm from, okay? So.